Today on Marie Clinics, we have a special package for single. Like, it's something that we've been expecting and it's something that they've been asking for via comments that when are you going to come up with singles tips, you know, to get them prepared for marriage, because the marriage itself is an institution and you need to prepare for it. You don't need to get there to got unaware. It's something that you need to prepare in your mind, in your spirit, that you want to go into before going there at all. So this today we are going to be doing justice to seven things singles need to watch out for while they are waiting. I call it waiting but not wasting. Waiting but not wasting. Many singles, why waiting on God, why hoping and trusting God for their spouse to come, they are wasting around doing sort of things, not adding value to their lives, not necessarily need to prepare because they feel that nothing good can come out of the Nazareth again, because they have tried countless of relationships and it wasn't working out. So I came up this day to tell you, you can pick your life from where it is right now and make it better, so that when your spouse arrive, he will meet that life, gather together, and he will be happy, or she will be happy that he has chosen the right choice for his or her life. Now, the word of God from the book of Isaiah 40 verse 31 says, those that wait upon the Lord, he will renew their strength. You know, it is a positive vibes that I'm trying to paint picture here, that when you wait on God, you are not going to waste out. You are not going to lose your strength. You are not going to be tired while waiting. God is the one that renews strength. If you have been praying and the answer has not come, keep at it. Keep praying. God never late. If peradventure he has not come now, he has a special package for you. And you know that a special package will dictate that you give a special time for it. So that wish that you have yet to receive, that spouse that you are yet to receive, is because God is doing something important about the person. And I pray when it comes, you'll be sensitive to know that it has come. We are the place, when we are waiting, we are the place where we see more of the Spirit of the Lord. Necessarily, when we are waiting, we are supposed to be in a place where the thing that we see must be the things in the spirit, not the thing in the world. Because if we put ourselves to the things in the world, we can lost in. We can lost in and not be able to trace back our footstep to God. Now, as a Christian sister, Christian brother waiting, it is important to work with your mindset. And you know, as you work with your mindset, be better in your work day in, day out with the Lord. See, how can you be better in your working workout daily with the Lord? It's because when you meditate on the word of God daily, when you want to know what God asks for you daily, and you don't joke with your prayer life, because all these two virtues is going to be a bedrock to your marriage when you get married. So you won't be caught unaware. You won't say, when I get married, I don't really even know that I will be praying this much. When I get married, I don't even know I'll be reading Bible this much. I've never married to be a pastor. I just want to live my life. I tell you, you can't say you just want to live your life, because you are responsible for God. You are responsible for God. So you need to take note of it. So I am here to share these seven vital truths. How you can be waiting and not wasting around. Number one is that, live your life. Don't wait till your spouse come before you start living. Many people are dying inside. They feel that nothing good can come out of their Nazareth. They have lost hope on everything. They can't even try any relationship. They have lost hope in having friends. They have been reduced in their thoughts. They want to live their life all alone. They are not living, they are dying. I tell you, if any part of your body has injury now, when the husband or the wife come, do you know that it's you have created another thing that they will be losing? So don't, because of many things that you are trying to get and you lost in thoughts, you're always off, you know, full of thoughts, thinking here and then. When they see you, they will even in your life, it is boldly written that you are waiting on God. It's boldly written in your countenance because you're not always happy. Because that brother has disappointed you. Because that sister said no again. You know, don't lose out. Live your life now, even before the spouse come. Don't wait till spouse come when you start, you know, bumbling up, start coming up alive. No, it might not, the time might not even be there. So start living your life now. That is number one secret why you need to know if you are waiting and you are not wasting. Number two is that focus on you, creating a better quality of your life by yourself. I think I mentioned this one of our video we uploaded recently that, you know, you need to get purpose for your life. Live your life. You know, focus on you first. The person that is coming to compliment you. You are not in any competition together with the person that is coming. So you need to live your life. And you know, when you live your life, it's like focusing on you. How can I be better in the area of my work, in my, you know, work with the Lord? What thing did I need to know? How far do I need to get knowledge from God? Revelational knowledge. How do I need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost? Because all these things that you're going to use is going to be there for you like a bedrock to your marriage. So focus on you. Leave the person that is coming. Let the person even meet you that you are fully packaged. Not that something is missing here and there in your life. So therefore, as a single watching or you're listening to this broadcast, please focus on you. Focus on your life. That is number two secret why you will know you are waiting and you are not wasting. Number three secret is that form or join a single platform. Don't say, I want to live my life myself. In fact, I don't want to let anybody get closer to me. Because the more I see people that are married, the more I feel irritated, the more I feel that God has forget me, God has left me to this place. See, when you get a good and a very positive group, please, I encourage you, join. There you can pray together. You can hold hands together and pray in the Holy Ghost concerning that matter. Don't ever feel that only you can walk this walk of waiting. See, when you are waiting, you see the like minds are also waiting. They might be older than you. That gives you courage that your situation is in the hand of God. It does not matter your age. But what I say is that when you have in your church, in your association, whereby you know that this is a positive vibe and they are going to add value to your life, please join. Because this will give you a sense of belonging. You see people you can share your things with, your experience with, people that can pray with you, people that can suggest to you what you can do at the right time, at the right place. See, I tell you, the Bible even said it, don't forsake the gathering of the saints. Don't say, after I join one, and no, try. Keep joining, keep praying together with people, and that will help you. The number four thing that you need to hold on to know if you are actually waiting and you are not wasting is that, you know, get your financial house in order. I love this one. Get your financial house in order. Don't necessarily live a life in debt. Don't think that, after all, when I get married, my husband will pay this debt. After all, when I get married, he will send me to school. After all, when I get married, he will give me money to do business. Get your financial house in order. Everything you have now, not necessarily be consumed by you now because you are still only one. Remember, you are going to get married. You have a whole lot to foot the bills. So save more as much as possible. What did I say? Save much as possible. If you have a money now, don't, because you think you are all alone to yourself, and start buying things you don't need. Buy things that you need. Save the rest. You might need it tomorrow. Don't ever think that, after all, I am a wife. I am a wife to be. I'm a wife to somebody. The person should take care of me. Hey, I love to tell you that many men today, they love an industrial wife. A wife that can support, not necessarily waiting on their money, but somebody that can be, you know, in their mind, producing, not that they are decreasing. So you too should be one of them. So be a wife that, or be a husband that, even when you get married, you don't need to start running everywhere to do little bills. You want to pay house rent, you start telling people, can you support? You know, all this thing does not even promote as a child of God. Now, the number 15 I will be mentioning is strengthen your relationship with God. This one is so important, and I love to say it again. I usually say it. Make sure that you are intimate with God, because it should not be easy for you to find your way with the Lord when you get married. It is what you have learned in time past that will be a kind of help for you when you get married. Make sure that your relationship with God is so cordial. Don't be intimate with God with what you want to collect from Him. That have been the game of the day before now, but now it has turned around. If you are intimate with God, it will show in your daily meditation, reading of the scripture, praying every day. Is it that He has done it, or is yet to come, or you are still waiting at it, or you are still trusting God, or you are still waiting on God? I tell you, your relationship with God is so important. And if you love God, let me give you as a bonus. If you love God so dearly, I tell you, freely, naturally, you will be able to love your spouse when they come. You will not naturally be tired of loving your spouse, because of what? There is a foundational love that flows out of you, which is the love of God. See, the Bible says, if you hate your brother, the love of the God is not inside of you. You can't even say you love your brother and you say you love God, and meanwhile your brother you don't love. The God that you did not see, how then can you justify your love? So when your relationship is key with God, it will draw near to you somebody that you will be able to love, and you will love each other one another respectively. Now, the sixth thing that you need to know, or to have the sense of belonging while you are wasting and not wasting, is that prepare for marriage. I tell you, marriage begets preparation. If you are not prepared, you will be caught unaware. Your expectation is going to be cut short, but I pray that will not be your portion. See, when you are not prepared for marriage, it's when you get in there, it will be like a burden to you. Do you know, as a wife, you need to submit? 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 1 to 7 is a word for both wife and husband. So don't get to marry and start feeling as if you are being enslaved. Am I the only one that must say yes all the time? Everything I say, you have to submit. Even if you have a contrary opinion to what your spouse, husband is saying, there is a way to go about it. Your submission is key to enjoy a successful married life. So that is why you need to prepare as a husband too. Do you know that you are going to love, even though those things that attracted you in the first place is no more there? The love, you know, must be at the peak, because everything that has gone up is going to go down. The love is going to depreciate. Things going to happen that you are going to say, but this is not where I met you. Then, are you going to reduce your love? No. Your walk with the Lord will say to you that you have loved Him or her. So be prepared. Don't come and be prepared while you are married. Prepare while you are still single. And your preparation is in the place of prayer, studying, getting to know more and more. Study your husband to be, study one another, study your own life, study your mood, study everything, and this will help you. The seventh thing you need to know that you are wasting and you are not wasting, and I want you to take note of this, is that determine the type of marriage you want to have. This one is so important. You know, there was a video we uploaded. I just want to encourage you to watch it, that making your marriage a covenant base. When you determine that the marriage I'm having, is not like the picture of what we have in the world, the better it is going to be for you. You know, the Bible, in the book of Genesis chapter 2, verse 18, the Bible says, it is not good for a man to be all alone, and I will make him an helpmate to help him, to help me, to complete him, not to compete together. So it is you that you know that in the marriage that I'm going into, we are not going to be enemy of ourselves. We are going to love ourselves. We are going to present the way Bible wants it. We are going to, try to present it to the world the way God wants it. Determine it now, why you are so single. And this closes for, because this is the 7 tips that you just need to take note as a singles person. When you have done justice to it by examining and re-examining and re-examining, the better it is for you, because it will be part and parcel of your life. Check your life. If these 7 are working in your life, if they are not, just keep at it. Pray together with the God and pray that He lays in your heart to learn it and learn it peacefully. Thank you for sitting back on this broadcast today, and we do hope that it has blessed you in one way or the other. As a single person, the best thing we can dream of is to have a successful marriage. Even while we are still single, we can be dreaming it, and I pray that the thought of God concerning that will come to pass in your life in the name of Jesus. I want to say this before I close, that thank you so much. We have received diverse of comments and likes, and people are sharing our video because it really helped one people or the other. So you could help us to share, you could help us to comment, you could help us like it. It goes a long way, and I pray that as you are deliberately not doing it, God is going to be your reward. Thank you, and stay back, and see you some other time. Bye.